More?
Well, yeah.
Our legs are crossing right now.
So great.
Yeah, right.
Didn't they tell you it's quite a sexy scene?
As long as it looks good, you know.
Okay.
It's not easy every day.
We worked two nights together. I remember the first day I arrived on Emily in Paris. It's a big machine, it's a big factory, and there's a lot of people, and you're trying to find your spot.
And when you arrive in that restaurant, you just... I remember you being on the side and just observing everything with such a benevolent look, and that's when I connected with you the most. I never told you that.
Thank you. So when you see an actor on TV, I think everybody is the same. Like, you think like the actor is the character. Mm. When I met you on the scene, it was like we were always joking and everything. Like,
yeah, that's I'm quite silly on set. The full kitchen is functional. Everything is functional. And we never got to use it in season one and two, really. Like, I would sometimes boil something just for the smoke and everything. But when you were here, we were always like walking on eggshells. Like, don't put your hands here, because everything was cooking. All the posts were at use.
When they are cooking on the other scenes, like, nothing is real. And when I was here, we was like really opening the fire and everything, because I was cooking. That was one, like, the scene was coming, and just Luca put his hand on the...
I think the grill thing.
I was like, oh, what? I just burned the main actor? I was like, everybody was screaming, like, Luca burned himself. So. When I was thinking on the menu for the show, I was like, even if nobody gonna taste it, it has to be good, because that's my spirit.
I remember being able to steal the plates when after we would shoot a sequence and be like, we're done with this one, and we would make like four of them. I would just like put them in boxes and go home. I think I speak for both of us when I say that it was such a pleasure and an honor, because I know it's escapism and entertainment, but I was trying to bring like a little message. And I wanted him to be vegetarian. And his kitchen in the first two seasons is very bourguignon, very old school French, yeah. Like, you know, meat, and then with your green star, we would like, there would be an honor for him to cook the menu. People don't know that it's an official menu just for that restaurant, with plates that really exist. Mm-hmm.
Be able to put this instability on the screen was like pretty cool for me. Mm. And my first like movie show. So.
The reason of climate change is the resources we use to feed the meat we eat. What made me vegetarian is my mother. My parents are vegan. I think every morning for the last 5 years, my mom would send me like slaughterhouses videos. Once you see those images, it's a choice to ignore them.
You want to save the animal. I want to just put the veggies on the top of the scene. So that's the same thing. I was thinking, like, what is a way to make people thinking differently? So I feel like I'm cooking, but with a goal. So life is different, and every morning is different.
It's interesting. I was thinking about it in season one, because I was a sous chef in a restaurant at some point. The more ready you are, the more effective you're gonna be when they call action.
It's funny what you say, because when I teach to my guys like how to work in a service, I always say to them, like, when the service is starting, it's like theater.
Have you tried any of the cooking?
Any of the what?
Any of his cooking?
Any of the what? He doesn't have time for this. He has a Michelin star. Why would he come to my place and try my cooking?
Yeah, but you can come here and bring me food.
I have like a very good risotto curry coco gambas.
I like Thai food.
From my mother, from her mother, from someone.
No, I'm hungry.
Me too.
But that's an idea.